Hello friends, in the previous video segments we have gone through the various BJT biasing techniques, and today we shall solve a few problems related to fixed or base bias. Just a brief recap, let's consider a circuit. So this is fixed biasing, where the resistance RB is connected between the supply VCC and the base. Let the current flowing through RC be IC, that is the current which is flowing to the collector. Let the current flowing through RB be IB, so that is the current which flows into the base, and let the current flowing from the emitter terminal be IE. There is no drop because there is no resistor connected. I have the base emitter voltage, which is VBE, and VCE is the voltage between the collector and emitter terminal. So if I need to find the operating point, I have to calculate the voltage across the collector emitter, which is VCE, and also find the collector current IC. So let's move on with the first problem. So in the first problem, a germanium transistor is given. The collector current IC is 1 milliampere, VCC is 10 volts. We need to find RB if beta equals 100. Let's write the equations first. We know that if I consider KVL along this path, I have VCC, that is the total voltage VCC, is equal to drop across the resistance RB, which is IB into RB, plus VBE. Similarly, if I consider KVL along this path, I have the total voltage VCC is equal to IC into RC, that is the current flowing through the resistance RC plus VCE. And we also know that IC is equal to beta times IB. So these are the relations which we need to use to solve any problem given for. So these are the expressions which I need to use if I need to solve any problem related to fixed bias or base bias. Now let's come back to the given problem. Since the transistor is germanium, we know that VBE, the base emitter voltage for a germanium transistor, is 0.3 volts. Therefore, I need to find RB. Now, to find RB, I need to use this expression. So we have VCC equals IBRB plus VBE. But IB is not known. IB is IC by beta, which is 1 milliampere divided by 100, which is 0.01 milliamperes. Therefore, what is RB? From this expression, RB is, I have VCC minus VBE, I bring VBE to this side, divided by IB. So VCC is 10 minus VB is 0.3 divided by 0.01 milliamperes. So when I calculate this, so this would be 9.7 divided by 0.01 milliamperes. So we would get 9700 kilo ohms. So this is the first part. So for the second part, I need to find IC for the same value of RB with beta equal to 50. Let us consider this expression. Now VCC is 10, so I have VCC minus VBE. VBE is known, which is 0.3 divided by RB, because RB remains the same, so that will be equal to IB. So we can find IB by using this expression. So VCC is 10 minus 0.3 divided by RB is 9700 K. So the value of IB is given. Now I need to find the value of IC. So this is IB. Now how do I calculate IC? IC is beta times IB. So beta is 50 here. So 50 into, so 10 minus 0.3, which is 9.7, divided by 9700K. So we get the value of IC to be 0.05 milliamperes. So we have found out the value of IC for beta equal to 50 for the same value of RB which we have calculated in part 1. Let's move on with the second problem. Now the second problem states that for the given silicon transistor, for the given figure shown with all the values, we need to find the operating point. So what has been specified? VCC equals 10 volts. Given RB equals 930 kilo ohms, RC is 4 kilo ohm, and then beta is equal to 100. We need to find the operating point, means that we need to find VCE and IC. Since the given transistor is a silicon transistor, VBE is assumed to be equal to 0.7 volts. Now first let us find IB using this expression. Now IB is equal to VCC minus VBE divided by RB. All the values are known. VCC is 10 minus 0.7 divided by 930 kilo ohms. So that would be equal to 9.3 divided by 930 K. We'll keep it as it is. What is IC? IC is beta times IB, which is 100 into this term, 9.3 divided by 930 K. So we get the value of IC as 1 milliamperes. Now we need to find VCE. I use this expression. VCE is equal to VCC minus ICRC, which is VCC is 10 minus IC is 1 milli into 10 power minus 3 into RC is 4 into 10 power 3. So we get the value as 6 volts. So therefore the operating point VCE comma IC equals 6 volts comma 1 milliamperes. A very easy problem. The third problem, we need to find the value of beta, VCC and RB for all the given values. Now what has been specified? IB equals 20 microamperes. So here between the emitter and the ground there is a resistor RE which is 0.68 kilo ohm, and this voltage is 2.1 volts. So therefore VE, the voltage between the emitter and ground, is 2.1 volts. VCE is 7.3 volts and RC has been named as RL. So we'll not be bothered about the nomenclature. So RL is 2.7 kilo ohms. So we need to find all these values. Now, if I write KVL along this path, I have VCC equals RL into IC plus VCE plus VE, right? So the total voltage here is nothing but drop across RL plus VCE plus VE. Therefore, these two voltages are known. I have VCE which is known and VE which is known. RL is known. We do not know IC, and VC is also not known. Next, I have VE. VE is the voltage across the emitter, which is RE into IE. Therefore, VE is 2.1 equals, what is RE? 0.68K into IE. So I can first calculate IE. IE is 2.1 divided by 0.68K. So we get the value as 3.088 milliamperes. Next, how do I calculate IC? We know that IE is equal to IB plus IC, which is IB plus, what is IC? Beta times IB, or 1 plus beta times IB. IB is known and IE is known. So we have 3.088 milli divided by 20 micro is equal to 1 plus beta. All right. So therefore, what is beta? This implies beta. If you calculate, you get the value of beta as 153.4. So this is the value of beta which we get. Now, using the value of beta, we can find the value of IC. Therefore, IC equals beta times IB, which is 153.4 into 20 micro. So the value of IC is 3.068 milliamperes. So we have found out the value of IC. So let me write all the values here. So IE is 3.088 milliamperes. We have found out the value of beta. Beta is 153.4, and we also have IC, which is 3.068 milliamperes. We have found out beta. We need to find our B and VCC. Now, can I use this expression? I can use this expression because VCE and VE is known. I have calculated the value of IC and RL is also known. So all the values are known here and we can find out the value of VCC. Therefore, VCC is equal to RL, which is 2.7 into 10 power 3 into IC is 3.068 into 10 power minus 3 plus VC is 7.3 plus V is 2.1. So when I calculate this, I would get VCC, which is 17.684 volts. So once we know the value of VCC, this is the voltage here, I have to apply KVL along this path. So what is VCC? VCC, the total voltage, is equal to drop across RB, which is IB RB, plus VBE, the drop between the base emitter terminal, plus the drop between the emitter and ground, which is VE. VCC is known, which is 17.68, equals IB is 20 micro into RB, plus VB is 0.7, VE is 2.1. So now we can easily find the value of RB. So if you calculate RB, so the value of RB would be 17.68 minus 2.8 divided by 20 micro. You get the value as 745 kilo ohms. So we have solved a few problems related to BJT biasing. Specifically, we have considered fixed or base biasing. So do make sure that you solve more problems so that you can solve any problem given under fixed or base bias very easily. And all the problems are very easy. As you have seen, you may be asked to find the value of RB, or they may ask you to find the value of beta, or you may be asked to find the operating point, which is VCE and IC. The problems are very simple. Take any textbook, keep practicing, and in the next few video segments, we shall solve some more problems on the other BJT biasing methods. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe, and press the bell icon to get notifications of all the further uploads, and thanks for watching.